What's up, folks, and welcome to an episode of Stars of Tomorrow, an FM20 series. We look at some of the young players on FM and see, or FM20, I should say, and we see how they get on over the course of their careers, both players that I've picked from my list and players that you guys suggest in the comment section. It leads me nicely on to, if you want to leave a player, please leave him down below. Leave as much info on that player as you possibly can. And we'll get round to him as soon as possible. I can't guarantee that every single player that you list in that list will be done, but I will do my best to make sure that I do that. Obviously, if it doesn't work out as much, then I may not release the episode, but most likely I probably will anyway. Down below, guys, second channel is up and running. We've got plenty of videos up that, on that channel now of Jedi Fallen Order. Twitch is back. I streamed yesterday, my time, which would be Sunday, your time, and with Fearless Foot Manager, usual thing, game pissed me off, and then it really pissed me off and infuriated me. Then all of a sudden things clicked out of nowhere and it was completely weird. But yeah, so today's player is Pellegrini. Now, also, before we go any further, actually, the new series is gonna be with Wolves, so it's a bit of a, if you watch this series, you've got a bit of a heads up there. I don't know when it's going to start because I'm waiting for a funnel to be made, and it's obviously my graphics guy is working on it as we speak. I may start recording it so I got videos ready for when we release episodes. But yeah, we do a Wolf series, so hopefully you look forward to that. I have no clue when it's going to start. I'm not going to guarantee it's going to be daily either. It might be, but I'm not going to guarantee that. So, Patrizio Pellegrini. Young striker from Monaco, signed season before for £22 million, currently worth 1.2, so again, gettable. Angers want him on loan, and Man City want to buy him. I don't think there's a loose clause in his contract, no there isn't. So key stats, likes first-time shots, finishing 14, decent jumping reach, good jumping reach, 15 jumping reach. Apart from that, it's all pretty level at the moment. So, first jump, guys, let's see how he gets on the early part of his career at Monaco, early part of this review. Well, folks, he's moved quickly to Lazio. He's now worth £9.5 million, got 16 finishing, good stamina, good jumping reach, a decent pace as well. He's got new player traits as well, which are run with the ball down the right, tries over kicks, tries tricks, and use first-time shots as well. So he's quite a flamboyant player. Just like other kicks and tricks. But he ain't got high flair, though, which is interesting. A nice little side note there for him. Just blow his back around a little bit. There we go. So, injury record. First, have a look. Not too bad. I mean, these down here don't really apply because, obviously, you know, it's pre-game. How has he done at Monaco? So, that year there, he didn't play much. Then got 8 goals and 1 assist. Then got 12 goals, 2 assists. Then got 3 goals. Obviously moved that year to Lazio for £16.75 million. And got 9 goals in that season. Again, not starting many games either. So, not a massive amount of money for a guy with 16 finishing, 30 composure and decent pace. Again, it's all about playing them early, guys. And using these players early. And not sitting there and letting them rot in reserves or on loan. Again, the game can't compensate for our ability to manage them. So, obviously, I think there's a good striker here. And not massively expensive either. I'm pretty sure last year it was a lot of money to get this guy out of Monaco. I'm talking like 100 million quid. I may be wrong in that, but I'm pretty sure it was. So yeah, next jump. Let's go. Well, folks, still at Monaco. No, it's not. Still at Lazio. Great stuff there. And we've actually seen a decrease in stats. I'm wondering if there's been a serious injury at this point to him. Same player traits, injuries, a 5-month injury there. And again, it looks a lot. Take the slight injuries out of there. Not too bad, is it? So, first year we saw, he got 9 goals. Next year he got 18, then got 15, then got 18, then got 4. That must be the serious injury. And got 19. So, the stats don't look amazing, but the goal return is very good. And I'm looking at, has he got placed shots? No, he hasn't. Just seems very just got good jumping reach. I'm guessing a lot of crosses in the box, maybe. Just a very good, solid goal scorer. And not a massive amount of money either. And this is at Lazio. So, you know, a decent league is Serie A as well. One of the top leagues in the world. So, averaging 15 goals a season, pushing 20. Yeah. Keep going. Well, folks, he stayed at Lazio throughout his whole simulation, apart from obviously starting at Monaco. And there's still the same traits. Nothing really changed here. In terms of, you can see the years. Obviously, he's 32 years old now. Injuries. Nothing other than a big fractured... I didn't realise that. It was a fractured skull. Good God. Damn it. Wow. I don't think I've ever seen that as an injury. I don't think I've ever suffered it either in the game. Again, I might be misremembering there. So let's have a look at his time. So we saw that season there didn't do much. Got 19 goals next season. Then 12, 18, 15, 20, 11. A really good goal scorer, guys. Cheap, a really good goal scorer. And again, who knows if you sign him early or use him in Monaco save long term. Who knows how well this guy, how good this guy could be for you. I think you've got a quality player here. He's not expensive based on this review. I would say, as always, buy these guys early. I think you've got a massive consistent goal score on your hands here. And who knows, you may get more of him down the line. But he's a player definitely, I think, more gettable this year. I'm certain in previous versions of the game, he's a lot more money from Monaco. But I think if it wasn't for that five-month injury for that fractured skull, who knows? And maybe if you played more in the early years as well, you never know what's going to happen, do you, really, with these players. So, yeah, good player. Really enjoyed him. Really enjoyed reviewing him. And I hope you guys, if you've signed him or you've played against him or you've seen him in your saves, how he's got on. So, yeah, thanks for watching, folks. If you enjoyed the video, hit the subscribe button, leave a like below as well. Also, down below, leave a comment about a player you want me to see me do next. Next player is a player from Benfica, Florentino Luiz, subscriber to this player. But until next time, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.